So as you can see, basic port security is very simple to set up. We made the port an access port and we enabled port security. Default violation mode is shutdown. Maximum MAC address allowed is 1. Port security is disabled by default, so you have to enable that. Now, there's a few things that you need to understand with regards to port security. Firstly, how a MAC address is learned. I showed you an example with dynamic. Basically, when traffic is sent by a PC, the switch learns the MAC address. And by default, the first MAC address that's learned is the MAC address that's permitted. You can also configure MAC addresses manually or statically. This is where you physically type in the MAC address that's permitted. That's a lot of work, however, so you may prefer to use sticky, where the MAC address that's first learned is written to the configuration of the switch. So by default, you only allow 1 MAC address. When a PC sends traffic, that MAC address is learned by the switch's MAC address table, but it's also written to the running configuration. You could determine that more MAC addresses are permitted and then either statically configure them or allow them to be learned via the sticky option. You also need to understand violation modes. We have shutdown, which I've demonstrated. That's the default. We have protect, restrict, and report. These are the three that we're going to concentrate on for the CCNA course. Basically, shutdown shuts the port. These two modes don't shut the port. But with protect, we have no logging. With restrict, we get logging. Let's start with how MAC addresses are learned, and then we'll talk about violation options. So first option is dynamic secure MAC addresses. The advantage here is that you don't have to manually type the MAC addresses. They simply learnt dynamically by the switch. You can configure the maximum MAC addresses allowed. By default, it's 1. Dynamically learned MAC addresses that are not secure are stored in the MAC address table until they age out. Dynamic secure MAC addresses do not age out by default. Instead, they are removed when the switch restarts or the port goes down. Remember, in my demonstration, the MAC address was shown as a static MAC address, not a dynamic MAC address in the MAC address table. Dynamic secure MAC addresses are not stored in the running configuration. As demonstrated on my switch, and I think I'll have to re-enable the interface because it's shut down, as you can see there, shut down, are not stored in the running config. So I'll unplug the one PC. So in my example now, I only have the one PC connected to the TP-Link switch, and the TP-Link switch is connected to the Cisco switch. Okay, so first thing I'll do is shut and no shut the interface to bring it up again, just to show you the options with dynamic. So show IP interface brief. Gigabit 101 is now up. You can also see that in the output here. Show port security. We can see that maximum MAC addresses allowed is 1. Current MAC address count is 0. So what I'll do is renew IP addresses on the PC. It's now got an IP address and it should be able to ping its default gateway, which it can. So I'll run that command again. Notice current MAC addresses went from 0 to 1. Looking at the interface, we can see that the port status is secure up. Interface is up at the moment. Last MAC address that was learnt, maximum MAC addresses is 1. Total MAC addresses is 1. Going back to the theory, dynamic secure MAC addresses do not age out by default. So if we show the MAC address table here, scrolling to the bottom, notice it's shown as a static MAC address. That's not going to time out. Other MAC addresses would time out as normal in the MAC address table. Last statement here, MAC addresses are not stored in the running configuration, so show run interface gigabit 101. The MAC address is not stored in the running config. That is different with other examples, however. So, secure static MAC addresses allow you to statically configure a MAC address. So you would manually type the MAC address into the switch's configuration. Going on to gigabit 101 as an example, we would type switchport port security. And here we would specify a MAC address manually, or we could use the sticky option to add a MAC address. So with static secure MAC addresses, you're adding the MAC address manually. So you would add that MAC address here at the end of this command. The MAC addresses are stored in the MAC address table and are added to the running config of the switch. You'll need to save the running config of the switch if you want to save that to the startup config. So if you specified a MAC address here, like something like this, that would be stored in the running config. Now we're told that it's reached the maximum limit because the switch has already learned that MAC address. So I'll just configure this on a separate interface. Let's say gigabit 102. So what we would type here, switchport port security, MAC address, and we could specify a MAC address. So I'll just do this on an interface that we're not using at the moment. And then we would type switchport port security, but notice it's not going to work because it's a dynamic port. So we have to type switchport mode access first and then switchport mode security. So I'll use do here to show us the running configuration. So do show run interface gigabit 102 in this example. Notice that it's an access port. Notice we've manually configured the MAC address and we've enabled port security. So if I type show port security now, we can see that we have port security on gigabit 101, but we also have it on gigabit 102 here. And if we look at that interface, gigabit 102, we've enabled port security. Maximum MAC addresses is 1, total MAC addresses is 1. We've configured a MAC address on that port. And if we look at addresses, we have statically configured this MAC address on gigabit 102, whereas this MAC address was learnt dynamically on gigabit 101. So that's the actual network that we're using at the moment. I've simply configured this MAC address manually on gigabit 102. So make sure that you understand that you can dynamically learn MAC addresses. You can statically configure them. The problem with statically configuring them is that you have to manually type them. So you'd have to find out the MAC addresses of the individual devices and then manually type them. So we have this option called sticky, where MAC addresses are dynamically learned and then stored in the MAC address table and added to the running configuration of the switch. When you save the running configuration of the switch, that information is saved to the startup configuration. And when the switch reboots, it doesn't have to relearn the MAC addresses. If the sticky secure MAC addresses are not saved, they will be lost. So I'll do that on, say, gigabit 103 before I do an actual demonstration. You would type switchport port security MAC address, and then you would specify the option sticky here. So show port security address. At the moment, no address has been learned on gigabit 103 because no traffic is being sent. I'll simply plug in the one PC at the top there into that port. What I haven't done is I haven't configured port security on that port. So show run interface gigabit 103. I need to enable port security. So interface gigabit 103, which command do we have to type first? Switch port mode access to make it an access port, and then switch port security to enable port security. So I went fast there. So I'll type show run interface gigabit 103. So you can see the configuration. Notice I typed this command and typed this command, but I didn't type this. This was automatically learned about the MAC address of this PC and automatically added that to the running configuration, and I enabled port security. So show port security now. You can see that we've got port security enabled on 3 interfaces. This interface is using sticky. This one I just configured a random MAC address. Here's the dynamic option that we learned. So show port security addresses. You can see this PC's MAC address was dynamically learned on gigabit 101. I configured a MAC address on gigabit 102. And this MAC address, which is the PC at the top here, was learned via the sticky option. So the difference is with dynamic, MAC address is not in the running configuration. With static, it's showing up in the running configuration because you type this command. With sticky, we type this command, but MAC address is automatically learned and added to the running configuration. Make sure that you know the differences between those options. If we type show port security interface gigabit 103, so the sticky one, notice port status, it's up at the moment. Last MAC address that was learned was this. Notice we see the sticky MAC address in the output here. Okay, so make sure that you know the difference between dynamic secure MAC addresses, static secure MAC addresses, and sticky secure MAC addresses. Okay, but what happens when there's a violation? I've already demonstrated shutdown, but we also have protect and restrict and report, but we won't worry about report for the CCNA course. With shutdown, as I've demonstrated, it's the default. Port is put in the error disabled state immediately, and an SNMP trap notification is sent. the violation counter increments. So on gigabit 101, notice we could see the violation count here is 2. Port is inactive while in the error disabled state. You as an administrator need to shut and no shut the port to bring it back again. That's a lot of hassle, but it's definitely more secure because your users are probably going to come to you and complain that the network is down. And you can ask them, what did you do? Did you plug in a Wi-Fi access point into that port? What did you do to cause a violation?